Kimbunga Hidaya kiliasili sana hapa.
We're going through a point of no return at 1.5 degrees of warming now. So we're really punching big holes in the matrix of coral reefs.
Maeneo mengi ukienda, utazoa takataka leo baada ya wiki moja zaidi ya zile.
But if we make the right decisions, all is not lost.
The countries, Tanzania, Mozambique, Madagascar, and the Comoros, come together collectively to make sure that marine resources are well protected, managed, and where they have degradation, they are being restored.
Watu wengi jamii ya watu wa pwani wanasema bahari haikauki, lakini mimi ninakataa. Bahari inakauka. Nilikuwa nawafahamu kasa kwa sababu nilikuwa ni mvuvi. Maono wangu wa mwanzo kwa sababu niliona kasa ni kiumbe wa kawaida. Na sasa hivi mimi nimebadilika. Sisense nafanya kazi ya utunzaji na utafiti wa viumbe wa bahari. Kasa hakuna sababu.
As a coral scientist, I started to look at the distribution of coral species in the Western Indian Ocean because it wasn't well known. I'm really a geographer biologist. I like looking at large-scale patterns. And as I went further and further afield, it became clear that the Northern Mozambique Channel is really the most vibrant part of the Western Indian Ocean for many species groups. We realized this is really the kernel, this is the center for our region. We called it the Northern Mozambique Channel Initiative. There's very hungry populations and very needy populations along the coastline, and the populations are growing. Overexploitation from fishing, coastal development, and population growth on land, all these are driving pressures on the Northern Mozambique Channel. So one of the main tools that we have to try and protect or sustain coral reefs and other systems are protected areas, or marine protected areas in the sea.
Mayai huwa tunatunza kasa mwenye anapotaja kule bichi. Tutaenda kupima sehemu nyingine ambayo tunaamini ni salama. Tutahamishia mayai kwa utaratibu. Kuhamasisha watu waache kumshambulia kasa na mayai yake. Mwanzo kulikuwa na changamoto kubwa. Unaweza ukaenda kijijini ukataka kuhamasisha watu ukapigwa au ukatukanwa. Wanasema kasa ni kiumbe tu, samaki Mungu amembeba. Lakini nafanya tafiti za uwepo wa kasa na mazingira yao. Kufanya utunzaji wa kasa kuna changamoto kubwa sana.
Around 11:59, the Tanzanian Meteorological Authority announced that Cyclone Hidaya had lost its strength. Mafia Island, which is about 130 kilometers from Dar es Salaam, has been really, really affected. We've seen a lot of images of houses that have been destroyed, roofs that have been destroyed.
Kimbunga kama hivyo kwa kwetu Mafia havijatokea. Kwa kimbunga Hidaya kiliasili sana hapa kijijini. Nyumba mpaka mazao yetu yalianguka.
The huge dilemma that is faced around protection of nature. It is the poorest that suffer the most from environmental degradation. People need food, water, shelter to survive, which they get from the environment.
Ambao wavuvi wanaokwenda kuvua kule, kuna marine park kule ambao ile hifadhi. Kwa hiyo sasa hivi nimejiboresha katika zao la mwani.
The future fishery will be better for them after some level of protection. What happens in the intervening period where they can't fish? How do we find the middle point to protect that area, and why is it beneficial for communities as well as for other people and for biodiversity as well?
So here's a map showing the Western Indian Ocean really well, the East African coasts and then Madagascar and the Mozambique Channel in between.
Mozambique Channel as a whole is often referred to as a highway for biodiversity.
Currents coming across the ocean from Indonesia through the Seychelles Islands. And as they kick off the tip of Madagascar, you create all these circular currents that whip down the Mozambique Channel.
And what that does is it just helps all these species accumulate. Coral reefs, they are distributed by currents. And as reefs decline, then the supply of larvae to downstream areas decreases. So what's happening with global warming now is that we're punching big holes in all the rest stops along the highways that the currents provide. Well, the data shows that maybe a quarter of all marine species are dependent on coral reefs at some point in their life stage. Once the corals are bleaching, we can't do anything about that. All we can do is watch it. But whatever other threats reefs are facing at the same time undermine their ability to resist that and recover from that.
We have to connect the dots. Just an example, if we have unsustainable forest management activities, it means soil erosion. We run through our rivers with lots of sedimentation, with lots of pollution. It's going to affect our mangrove. It's going to really bleach our coral reefs, which is habitat and a breeding site for fish. But how do we make sure that the water which flows into the ocean has minimal pollution? Be it land-based ecosystem, be it water-based ecosystem, be it marine-based ecosystem, the community members have to be actively engaged. And WWF works with communities in a number of fronts. In the oceans, we have beach management units, but we also have community-based forest management groups. These are community members groups put together, and they develop bylaws on how they can effectively use resources for their own good, but also for nature.
Nipo kwenye kikundi cha vikoba mkombozi juani. Kwa hiyo baada ya kujuana nyumba fulani amta imetenguka, nyumba fulani imebomoka, tukaanza kusaidiana maisha ya jamaa zetu wengine kuanza kujengewa.
Setting aside part of the cost as man and biosphere reserve, it means the communities who dependent on marine resources for their livelihoods are going to be deprived. So you need to provide an alternative source of income. Seaweed is part of the blue forest. That part of ecosystem is really important for the marine resources, habitat for marine resources, food for marine resources, but also they have other values.
Wakaja kutupa simina kidogo pale ofisini ya mwani. Wakaja kutuletea na kamba. Kwanza kula kama mwani tulikuwa hatujui kama mwani unaliwa.
Instead of selling it raw, of which you can sell it at a lower price, you process it, you repackage it, you brand it, then you fetch even a higher price in the market.
Tukaja tukapata tena mafunzo kwamba tutengeneze bidhaa zetu hazo za mwani. Najivunia mkulima wa mwani na vikoba na changamoto navyo. Pesa nilopata kwenye mwani nimejengea nyumba, sasa hivi naishi na familia yangu. Najivunia sana.
So in the ocean, just like on land, there's ripple effects to everything. I mean, you know, the ocean has waves. That's where the term ripple comes from. Until now, we may not have been aware of those ripple effects, so we have ignored them. But with better tools, especially satellite imaging, we can see those ripple effects happening.
Kishafika kwenye lile eneo la tukio, sasa tunafanya kwanza usafi kwenye lile beach. Kwa hiyo tunasaidia kuangalia wanyama wengine ambao wanataka kula watoto wa wakasa, lakini pia tunaangalia ndege juu. Lakini nyingine tunafanya turtle satellite tag. Yenyewe inatuwezesha kujua kasa anatembea umbali gani.
Once sea turtles hatch, the young go into the water and they may migrate around for 5, 10, 20 years in a particular route around an ocean basin and then come back to mature adults to the same beach that they were laid on. So if any place in that point is degraded, you know, that could break the life history of the turtle.
In this map, you can see individual nest tracks of turtles. We can use them as an indicator of the intactness of the system as a whole and how that changes over time.
The great story there is that sea turtle numbers are increasing in East Africa and around the Northern Mozambique Channel as a result of many of these efforts.
Mimi sijawahi kuchoka kazi yangu kabisa. Nikimwona kasa amerudi kutaga tena na isika ndugu yangu kabisa.
Things can recover, we can rebuild populations. But it's not just about local commitment, we need global commitment. If we make the right decisions, all is not lost.
Thanks so much for watching. For more videos like this, subscribe to the United Nations Environment Programme.